A very good morning, friends. Today we'll discuss about an important topic, that is purine nucleotide catabolism. In the catabolism of purine nucleotide, there is a synthesis of uric acid and increase or decrease concentration of uric acid in blood is related to the different diseases, that is, for example, gout, then Lesch Nyhan syndrome, then severe combined immunodeficiency, then purine nucleotide phosphorylase deficiency. So these are the disorders which are related to the serum uric acid level. Now coming to the degradation of purines, this adenine and guanine, these are the purines. In the metabolism, the nucleotide, that is adenosine monophosphate, then inosine monophosphate and guanosine monophosphate, they are acted upon by the nucleotidase, and converted into adenosine, inosine and guanosine. There is release of inorganic phosphate by the action of nucleotidase. Then this AMP, it is converted into IMP and adenosine is converted into inosine. This is with the help of AMP deaminase. This is adenosine deaminase. This is important. Deficiency of this enzyme lead to the disorder known as severe combined immunodeficiency, due to the adenosine deaminase deficiency. And gene therapy was tried first time on this disease, that is severe combined immunodeficiency. Now this inosine, it is converted into hypoxanthine, then xanthine, and then uric acid. So uric acid is the end product of purine catabolism. This guanosine, it is converted into xanthine. This inosine is converted into hypoxanthine with the help of purine nucleotide phosphorylase. There is a release of ribose 1-phosphate. This reaction is also here, purine nucleotide phosphorylase. There is a release of ribose 1-phosphate. And it will give, the inosine will give hypoxanthine and guanosine will give xanthine. Now there is one important enzyme, that is xanthine oxidase. This is metalloflavoprotein, which contain iron, FAD and molybdenum. This is important in the uric acid synthesis. In this reaction, the water molecule plus oxygen lead to the formation of free radical, that is H2O2. So this is purine nucleotide degradation, in which AMP, IMP and GMP, it is ultimately converted into uric acid. This is important enzyme xanthine oxidase. In the gout, there is hyperuricemia, serum uric acid goes above the 7 milligram per deciliter. And in the treatment of this gout or hyperuricemia, we give allopurinol as a drug of choice. This allopurinol inhibits xanthine oxidase by two mechanisms. First one is the competitive and another one is the suicide mechanism, and decreases the uric acid level. So this is about the degradation of purine nucleotide. There are four important disorders: gout, in which there is increased uric acid production which lead to the accumulation of monosodium urate crystals in the joint. Treatment is allopurinol and NSAID drugs. Then Lesch Nyhan syndrome, it is due to the deficiency of HGPRTase, that is hypoxanthine guanine phosphoribosyl transferase. It is typically characterized by the self-mutilating behavior, and it is a X-linked disorder, typically affects the male. Also, there is mental retardation in Lesch Nyhan syndrome. In severe combined immunodeficiency, it affects the T cell and B cell function due to the deficiency of adenosine deaminase. And purine nucleotide phosphorylase deficiency also causes the decrease in uric acid level. So in gout and Lesch Nyhan syndrome, there is increased uric acid, and in SCID and purine nucleotide phosphorylase deficiency, there is decrease in the uric acid level. The normal uric acid level is 3 to 7 in males, and it is 2 to 5 milligram per dl in females. When it goes above the 7, it precipitates as a monosodium urate crystal, affects the joints. In gout, the first metatarsophalangeal joint is typically affected. So this is all about the purine nucleotide catabolism. Thank you. Keep watching.